His story in words, so I'm going to save that for him. But I am so honored and humbled to be in his presence, and it wouldn't be for us meeting without Kirsten Harkin and her husband Pat, who came here, and the dog, who came here from Laguna. But Kirsten was and is a collector. And she reached out to me and was like, Monica, and we see eye to eye on all of our art tastes. And she goes, this man is so incredible. If you can get him and represent him, it will be absolute magic. And so I owe our union to Kirsten, and I thank you so much. Tonight is also about so much positive energy, and Halim and I have been reflecting on that. There's no reason why the two of us should have met outside of Kirsten, but his story is so magical, but the energy around it is so unique. His mother worked at the U.S. Library of Congress. I'm sorry, I'm a little bit nervous. And she is still a positive influence in his life. He is such an intellect in so many ways. You will see throughout his art the stories, but also the words and the meaning behind all of this is so intellectual on so many different levels. He spent many years in prison, but every day he studied and read and studied more, got his GED, his master's. He published 11 books, wrote poetry, all within the confines of prison. And it's just humbling for me in particular to understand how somebody could come out of that without any resentment. And so what you will see in all of these pieces that are reminiscent of Keith Haring, Picasso, Basquiat, but more importantly, it's Halim's language. It's his own language of love. And so in every single piece, there is an element of love, but there's also his own language. Like, see the love below the surface, S-I-R-F-A-C-E, right? There's also interconnectedness. Within each piece, there's so much dynamic words and meaning and intellectual aspects. I will, at this point, give it to you because tonight is
our night.
But it's also like incredibly special that we have him here in our town. So with that, I thank you for being here.
I want to begin with it's a poem I wrote today. It's titled By the Sea. I wonder what do they see when they see me by the sea. Texture of each stroke, layering my audacity to be. Is it a painting on a wall? Or the pain of the waves dichotomy. What do they see by the sea when they hear not for sale? Solitary confinement of the mind is more confining than a jail. Can they see by the sea the waves of generosity is a currency of love underwritten by philanthropy? Shades, cool or warm, the audacity to love in the storm. To see by the sea, when the earth was our form. By the face of the deep, on the shores where colors become blind, can we see by the sea, beyond the prison of space and time? I wonder what we can see by the sea, between the world and me, the thread of humanity, transcending I into we. So for me, I'm thankful to be here, extremely grateful. I believe in love. I believe in alchemy. I believe in energy. I believe in the law of attraction. And as I was explaining to George, I don't believe it, I know it. And so when I was in prison, I was 16 years of age. I knew I was innocent. They told me I was a super predator. I was a menace to society. I was a violent offender, a convict, all these things that they tried to impose upon me, but I knew I wasn't those things. And I had the audacity to love myself, because it takes an insurmountable amount of love as a child to go up against a system that crushes nations in its might, and to still have that belief in your humanity, that belief just in yourself. And so it's by the power of literature and the arts. Like, it was divinely ordained that I had a mom that worked at the Library of Congress. She would Xerox copy every text that I can think of and read about in the Wall Street Journal and the Forbes and the Burns and the Kiplinger Report. I'm studying the Federal Reserve and Albert Einstein. And, I mean, my mind was just, it's like I was in a cave like Plato, but I was really like in the playground, because I controlled my perspective as to where I was at. And so, by the power of love, by the power of the capital of imagination and alchemy, I was able to transform a very inhumane condition into a golden opportunity. And so I stay here today, not, when I say not for sale, C-E-L-L, it's not just about my individual experience with being inside of a prison for 22 years, but it's the prison that exists in our mind. We very rarely can be without fear of meeting someone's expectations of how we should show up and who we should be. And so for me, the not for sale is like freeing our minds from all of these constructs of race, class, gender, creed, disability, age, sexuality, all these things that just that divide us and create hierarchies as to who is important and who is not. And so I'm thankful for everyone that's here today. I hope that the art created a vibe and an experience. I hope that this talk created a vibe and experience. I stand on the shoulders of my mom, a woman 4'11". Love me unconditionally. I met a woman, Kirsten. I met a woman, Monica. My story is just like about women, mostly. Just like, you love me. Like, sometimes men just didn't get it.
They don't.
Their wives didn't. And so the guys just signed a check. And so, in closing, I just want to end with a piece. And this is a piece that I wrote. It's titled When They See Us. And before I close with this piece, I never painted. I never drew, I never sketched. In prison, I started my own publishing company. I knew I had to like get my story out. If not, they wanted me to die in prison. So I started my own publishing company. I published 11 books. And through that, I was able to meet some phenomenal individuals and organizations to change legislation and to get not only myself out, but a lot of other children in the District of Columbia who were given life sentences as kids. And so when I got out in March 21st, 2019, I had a year of experience in the world and public speaking and doing spoken word and, you know, selling books and things of that nature. And then the world went in lockdown, right, in the quarantine. And so this is when I started to paint, because all of my in-person events were canceled. And I was like, well, I can't get out and speak and recite the poetry, but let me just paint it. And it's a phenomenal art collector, a woman named Agnes Gunn. She saw the documentary 13th, and she read the book, The New Jim Crow. And she was so moved after seeing the documentary 13th, she looked for something to do about what was going on with mass incarceration. So she sold her favorite Roy Lichtenstein painting for $160 million. And she gave away all the money with the instruction that it had to be given away within 5 years to artists who use their art in the interest of social justice. So it was from the grant that I received from her when I came home from prison that I had the seed capital to invest in painting while we were locked down and still be able to pay my mortgage and my car notes. And so, like I say, I just stand on the shoulders of women.
Wow.
And so, a woman's love is like the sun. And so, it's there even when it's cloudy. But this piece is titled, When They See Us. I'm not going to write poems about people judging people. I'm going to speak and write poems about people loving people. See, the problem is much bigger than class and race. It's really not a political war, but a spiritual battle between love and hate. See, if it's going to take a village, then the village is going to need love. So when they see us, they don't see us as killers and thugs. So when they see us, they see us and don't judge. So when they see us with eyes full of love. It's not about conservatives and liberals reaching across the aisle. It's about reaching into our hearts to extend a loving smile. See, the labels are fables that separate us from our truths. We all need to just weed the weeds to see the love in our roots. Love is the revolution, and compassion be our bullets. Empathy is the trigger for forgiveness to pull it. Freedom is our target, and unconditional love be our goal. With our civic engagement starting at the seat of our soul. Grace plays the symphony as just mercy plays the band for the Lady of Liberty to love and accept all in this land. Love is the revolution. Thank you.